we're in a transformational and generational shift that we've never seen in our careers. California high-speed rail is under construction now, and we're about to have high-speed rail in this country. There's over 119 miles under construction right now in California, infrastructure projects that have significant regional, statewide, and national benefits. Those benefits are varied between resolving congestion in communities, current condition around climate change, reducing greenhouse gas emissions, and they're also about quality of life in terms of people being able to travel between major cities comfortably, reliably, and safely.
We're working in the Valley, the largest agricultural center in the United States. This is CP4, and it's 22.5 miles approximately, going from the Tulare County line down to just outside the city of Shafter. We are working directly for California High-Speed Rail to manage the construction of this section of the program.
CP4 is part of the 171 miles initial operating segment for California High-Speed Rail. The most exciting part about CP4 is that this is going to be the first civil infrastructure dedicated for high-speed rail in North America. So that's very exciting for us. This sends a really clear message that high-speed rail is here, and the high-speed rail is possible to be done in California and the United States.
You know, you're giving many travel options to the travelers. That's one of the major advantages of the program. In addition, there will be an economic benefit to California, as well as the easing of the congestion, the traffic congestion, the pollution, etc.
I'm excited that high-speed rail is picking up, and I'm excited to be part of the first part here in California that's going and leading the way. And hopefully we can have many more projects like that and have high-speed rail that can help everybody, because it's a very good, clean way of going around and traveling.
Out on the guideway, they use a through girder design. So most of the load in these structures is carried in the parapets. They're large, they extend well over the train, and they're post-tensioned. So the weight of that bridge is transferring to those parapets, to the sides, and then down into the piles in the ground. The most interesting part about the Wasco Viaduct is the design.
To avoid the disruptions to BNSF, the team chose a pergola-type structure. And then we used a lot of precast elements so that we can do most of the construction on either side without affecting BNSF too much and their operations, and then set the girders over BNSF when we had the closures and make everything happen.
The pedestrian underpass is an interesting structure. It's beautiful. I think for the city of Wasco, again, it's a signature structure, a signature area, allowing Amtrak patrons to go underneath high-speed rail and up the other side to the station platform.
The beauty of the construction is to have these challenges. That's the beauty, to be able to learn from other people, and we will connect California for sure.
High-speed rail's sort of sweet spot is where it's competitive with air, particularly that high-speed rail can operate from center city to center city. There's a much higher reliability. The weather issues are not as significant. Plus, the ability to expand capacity is much easier because you can just either add more trains or add more cars on a train to increase capacity.
From my perspective, the most exciting part about CP4 and our leadership on CP4 is that we don't just want to participate in the development of a project. We don't want to just help them build a high-speed rail project. We believe in high-speed rail. HNTB has been able to lead in a way that has used all of our national resources and bringing those to bear, and using the skills and the leadership of a very talented team of people to ensure that the structures that are part of the construction package for section are delivered on time and on budget.
I think the next
10, 20 years is going to be very important to us. We're going to start seeing a lot of the European technology be coming in. Right now, we have infrastructure that's been built in CP4, the Wasco area. But the next phase of the project is basically bringing a train system inside here, picking the right train system, and running the train system at 220 miles an hour.
San Francisco to LA is one of the busiest travel corridors in the world and will continue to be so. And if we want to continue to be economically competitive on a global scale, we'll have to be able to maintain mobility and the ability to move both goods and people between north to south in California. Making California high-speed rail a reality and our work on CP4 is instrumental, is critical to making that happen.